This short video will introduce you to 2D work instructions using XVL and solutions from Lattice Technology. I will show you how easily these instructions can be created and options for deploying them to your shop floor users or those performing service. If you're responsible for documenting assembly or service instructions for your company, I think you'll find this video valuable. Creating 2D-based work instructions is just one of the many solutions available from Lattice Technology using XVL. You can use XVL to leverage your 3D CAD models to all parts of your organization. XVL is uniquely suited to repurposing your 3D CAD data for these reasons. XVL is CAD agnostic. All major CAD formats are supported. Even multiple formats can be included in a single instance. XVL is ultra lightweight, usually less than 1% of the original CAD model size. Entire models, even extremely large models, can be loaded as a single instance. And lastly, XVL maintains CAD level accuracy, even though it is ultra lightweight. This is required for precise planning for assembly or service. Is there a clash? What is the clearance? Can the tool be inserted? Is there access for a human to complete the operation? Now for our featured topic, creating 2D graphical-based work instructions delivered with PDF in three easy steps. Step one, define the process. This is a bike engine maintenance example with two processes, disassembly of the engine and disassembly of the clutch. Processes are noted with circles and are comprised of tasks, which are noted with triangles. Creating this process tree is not the subject of this video, but suffice it to say, it is built within our suite of tools using drag and drop and is the basis for creating work instructions. Step two, take the snapshots and author the instructions with annotations. After the processes and tasks have been defined in the previous step, it's time to take the snapshots. Snapshots are the graphical building blocks for the work instructions. A snapshot can be attached to the process level, and each task can have one or more snapshots. Step three, publish the 2D work instructions using Microsoft Excel with user-defined templates. Here you can see the graphical representation of the task of removing the carburetor, the second task of this process. And that's it for the overview. Now let's go into more detail on step two, the authoring process. Our standard tools for creating technical illustrations are used to create these annotations. Everything is hyperlinked, cross-sectioning can be used, text notes can be added, although we recommend documenting with graphics whenever possible. In this example, a warning has been added about the crankshaft alignment. And a main view can be created with supporting views. And now, more detail on step three, publishing. The snapshots with annotations are published into Microsoft Excel using a template. We provide an easy-to-use tool for creating the template, so all of your instructions can be quickly and easily formatted into your company's format. No program is required for creating the template. Hyperlinks have already been added between the graphical representation and the bill of materials. The labels that begin with LTC are the actual part names and link to the part descriptions in the BOM. You can share the Excel spreadsheet, or you can use Excel to publish a PDF document. And that's it. Now it's time to share. Here's a PDF document published from Microsoft Excel, which is the workflow we recommend. These work instructions can then be deployed on anything that supports PDF, including tablets and phones. Of course, you can print the paper instructions. Here you see the hyperlinks in action between the parts list and the part geometry. Notice also the multiple snapshots for a task, like removing the carburetor, with supporting snapshots showing alternative views and what surfaces to clean. And that's it. Thanks for watching.